We have had to slow down a couple times already to gawk at deer. Why don't you look out the window?
Just under a half hour before sunrise at 5:52. But the day is definitely already dawning. The sunlight is already quite a bit brighter than moonlight. Oh, somebody's in the overlook already. Two cars. Well, heck, we may have to park in the grass. Okay, we are parked at the Dripping Rock Overlook. I guess it's a little dark for that rock. We're not going to have much more video until we get a little more sunlight. So we are starting north on the Appalachian Trail. Try to get to a high spot to watch the sunrise. Well, we've made it over the little top that's right next to the road and down a low place that has some houses beside it. Went past two springs down at the bottom of that and starting back up again. And this is up to a much higher top. And we just saw our first deer out here in the woods. Okay, we are really starting to gain a little altitude now. Getting into a real rocky area. But steadily getting brighter. We get out of the canopy, it'll really brighten up. Oh, this is like going upstairs. You see anything? Anything moving? Well, we have reached a big rock pile on the east side. Goes this way. I'm hoping we come out on a high clearing here somewhere. We can sit down and cool off and watch the sunrise. Through that big rocky area and we're on the local top. We just passed two different campers. One sitting in his tent and one putting his tent away. I saw two cars down in the parking space, so I guess they just came up here for a pleasant night's sleep. Oh, we have some wild columbine hanging down over the trail. Haven't seen any of them for a while. Yeah, it looks like we're starting downhill here pretty soon. I'll bet it's a steady downhill all the way to the picnic area. Well, I think it's definitely after sunrise, but from this part of the trail, we have humpback rock between us and the horizon. And we're not quite as high as humpback rock, so we have to wait for the sun to get up above the rock before it can actually throw sunbeams down on us. So we're still getting indirect light. But it must be about 6 o'clock. Now this is a big rock that's on the east side of the trail. The moon is still up, but it's getting kind of insignificant compared to the sunlight. getting bright. This looks a lot like Raven's Roost. Big rocks. We went along the right side of these on the Appalachian Trail, marked in white. Looks like this was the old Appalachian Trail, and now they've painted it over with blue. That's an interesting side trip. So somewhere we're going to have to go down. A whole bunch of down to get back to the Appalachian Trail. I got to find another blue spot. Where do they recommend we go down? That way? Maybe that way. Back to the steep rocky part. Got a little cliff running over that way. Probably about almost halfway back from our farthest point. It was just barely light enough to take video when we came through here half an hour ago. Let's go. Just below this steep part, a deer stepped across in front of us on the way up. She's on high alert now in case it moseys back through. She likes to see deer, but she doesn't know if she wants to track them like a beagle or a basset hound, or herd them back to me like a blue heeler. So she's just interested. The last hump before we go down to the car, and we're finally getting our first sunbeams at ground level. So when we get to the car, it'll be sitting in the sunshine. Coming back down to the parking area, and the sun is right there, so that's east. That means turn right is south. So to go north on the Appalachian Trail, at this point, you have to go south. It has a big S-curve in it. So you're actually going the wrong way for a little while before you turn around and get going north. Well, nobody said it was a super highway. Sheila says there's almost enough water here to cool off after a hike. Huh, almost enough to cool off. Can you cool your tummy? Oh yeah, that's pretty good. That overflowed it a little bit. Good girl. Now I'll have to get all dried off. Okay, let's go dry.